I was born a colored man, and don't you forget it, but I lived as a colored woman for 17 years. The words of Kansas-born slave Henry or Henrietta Shackelford, who in the novel The Good Lord Byrd becomes one of the ragtag followers of the abolitionist John Brown and survives to tell of the raid on Harper's Ferry. This is the third novel by James McBride. He's also author of the best-selling memoir The Color of Water, a black man's tribute to his white mother. And first, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
So the story of John Brown has been written and written about in nonfiction and fiction. You, what, felt you had something more to tell?
Well, I wanted to tell it in a funny way, and I wanted people to know about him, and I tried to come up with a way to tell his stories that was compelling and funny, I suppose.
Fun, you used that word twice. This is a very funny book about a very serious subject. I mean, why did you want to put humor into it, into the life of John Brown, and slavery?
Slavery is such a droll subject, and it's depressing. I didn't want to write a book that was depressing. You know, I don't want to read a book that's depressing. So I just thought that, and John Brown was so funny. I mean, he wasn't funny. He was actually had no sense of humor at all,
right,
which made him a perfect person to make fun of.
All those pictures of him and the you know,
so strict. And,
yeah,
you know,
yeah, yeah.
Just so stern looking, and he was very religious, and it just made him a perfect caricature item.
Well, and in your telling, he's often going on and on with the prayers forever, mangling passages from the Bible, right?
Well, he mangles the Bible pretty badly in my book, but in real life, he was probably more cognizant of the Old Testament than most people he came across.
So you used the word caricature. Was that the intention from the beginning? Or, I mean, is that a way into what is it a way into in
historical
terms of a story
novels
like this?
Are hard to do for the general public,
yeah,
for the commercial writers like myself.
Yeah.
So I had to create something that would allow people room to laugh at things they can't really talk about easily. And that was really the point of it, to kind of give people space to laugh at everyone so they can see some of the truths inside the historical facts.
And the way in is this wonderful character, Henrietta, who's nicknamed by John Brown Onion, Little
Right.
Onion, right? A vernacular voice that you write in, a black voice telling this story.
Well, I love that old country, you know, that old country talk. You know, we still have a lot of Americans who talk like that, black and white, that sort of direct black vernacular of, you know, I was born by the river and you know, the kind of hee-haw chit-chat.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the old men in my family talk like that. And I always wanted to find a way to put that in a narrative, and this was just the perfect place.
So you just had fun with it? How did you do it?
I just had fun with it. Well, once the character Onion became real to me, I just fell into his voice. I mean, in real life, I was going through a lot of personal trauma, you know, divorce, my mother died, and my niece passed away, and this was a chance for me to just have fun with someone, to dip into a world with a character who had deep problems, but just managed to laugh them off and kind of keep moving.
In along the way, you're messing with some big icons. I mean, John Brown, of course. Frederick Douglass comes in for a cameo here, and it's not the most reverent view of Frederick Douglass I've ever read, that's for sure.
Well, yeah, I got scorched a little bit by that Frederick Douglass depiction. But it is funny. And Frederick Douglass in real life was married to a black woman and had a white mistress, and they lived in the same house together. I mean, that, you know, you can't do that in Brooklyn now. I mean, I don't know where you can do it. I mean, maybe the place where you can do it, but I mean, my point is that it's just ripe for cracking a joke about it.
So did you start? I mean, the inevitable question is how much did you feel you had to stick to facts? Did you do research and then throw it all aside or check your facts along the way? Because you also have a past as a journalist, I happen to know. Too,
yeah, well,
right?
I've made sure to make people understand that this is a novel. But I'd say about 70 to 80% of it is true. The basic facts are quite true. I mean, they couldn't be truer. I took some liberties with John Brown's praying, I mean, you know, and some of his language. The facts are, John Brown did do the things he did. He was, you know, he was against slavery, and he fought in the wars in Kansas, and then he attacked Harper's Ferry, and he Frederick Douglass did ask Frederick Douglass to join him, and Frederick Douglass said, no, are you crazy? You know, this is a suicide mission. Mm-hmm. And John Brown did fumble through life. He was a failed businessman. He failed at a lot of things. And he always managed to do things, but he never did them on time. The train just kind of rumbled forward, but it never arrived on time and with the passengers on it that should have been there.
You know? And just briefly, how did you come to see John Brown in the end?
I loved him. I mean, I grew up in the church, and he was very religious, and that was one of the things that really attracted me to him. And the power of religion that made him so, that made him such a force, is something that still exists in my own life. So I really admire him. I admire him now more now than I did when I first learned of him.
All right, we're going to continue this conversation online, but for now, the book is The Good Lord Bird, National Book Award winner James McBride. Thanks so much, and congratulations.
Thank you very much. Delighted.